questions about modern me.
Oh, Well, we waited a long time. I shouldn't wait any longer. I shouldn't wait any longer to say welcome. We're so happy to be here back at the Garden. Great to see you, New York. We'll talk more later, yeah? No, actually, we start that again. You know, I don't want to wait till later. I just have to say it right now. Because it's on all our minds, and I mean, we'll talk more, but I do want to address that, you know, this is I believe I was told it was the 37th time this band has played in New York City. In perspective, I think we've only played Seattle 50, so this is... But here's the thing, and I don't mind saying it publicly, I don't remember half of those fucking Seattle shows, I just don't. But I feel like we've remembered every New York City show that we've ever had, you see. And this potentially has the chance to be the most memorable of them all, because it is quite... Potentially none more than tonight, because we are quite honored to be spending this important date with you. And we're so honored to have you all here. We have friends and family. We have people that traveled from all over the country to be here. And it carries a lot of weight that there's so many first responders that were able to make it out tonight. And we're playing this song, this show for you.
So you had to go, oh, and I To live
in the present tense. On how this life ends. Check your hands and study your lines. Have you the belief that the road ahead ascends on? Seems for most I see it's getting harder to find an approach and a way to live. Yeah. Oh, yeah, something I don't miss. Oh, man, fucking trip. we don't have to stop it. Alright, there's just a little bit of thing. We got this. Dudes in a little bit of a small space. These things happen. We'll just go outside and talk about it for a minute. Situation. It's okay, man. Let's bring back the positivity, please. Turn the volume up on the positivity, please.
Yeah.
If I could just take one moment and say that back home in Seattle, there's a friend of ours, a very, very incredible, special person. She plays in the WNBA. She's arguably the greatest women's player ever to play the game. She played her last game in Seattle last week. We wish we could have been there, but we were in Canada. No, we like Canada, but she's so important to us and to our city. So I just wanted to say that we're still thinking about her. She's on our mind, and we wish her the best in this next part of her life. And I'm talking about the amazing Sue Bird. Is there anybody else we know here? Oh, shit. Somebody else is going to slow down playing. I don't even know how to say it. Look, I'm just going to say that there's two other women that are probably the most inspiring female athletes. I don't want to be hyperbolic about it. I'll just say that we're just deeply honored and so glad we get to be in the same room with two of our all-time favorites. Everybody in this band loves them, and I think you all love them too. But hey, thanks for coming to the show, Venus and Serena. They could beat me tennis and karaoke. We'll be right back. Mr. Mike McCready on the Stratocaster.
Best day.
familiar. A friend up here on the stage. I met him all these years ago in a tiny little spot on the Hawaiian Islands. He was playing keyboards in this little group. It was like a porch and a dirt yard and a few Hawaiians playing music and then, man, this guy on the B3 organ. I could not believe what I was hearing with this guy on this deserted side of a tiny island was doing playing this kind of B3. And now for, I reckon, 20 years maybe, he's been on the road with us playing keyboards, the B3 organ. It's one of my favorite stories I ever heard in music. And he's here tonight in Madison Square Garden, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Boom! Yes, man.
Yeah. Oh,
Thanks for listening in New York City. Your voices feel important. Thank you. Hold me closer, Chloe, dear, and still. All the headlights on the highway. Me alone, oh. one's for Steve. A song by the Dead Boys, and they're not all dead. Just want to get my thoughts together for just a second before I think it's important that we just recognize for a moment, you know, the conversation that I got to have with some of our first responders that are here tonight. And it's a great privilege to get to hang out. And, these are like gentle giants, you know, they're big guys on the fire department. And You could tell that they, you could tell their hearts were very sensitive. And they were probably always that way. And now they've had to be on the mend for how many years now? And, you know, he said something profound to me, which was that is the first time he'd ever been back in the city on this date, because he usually tries to get as far away and block his mind, maybe be out on a lake or on a boat or somewhere far away. But he felt that this would be a positive thing to be with all of you here tonight, and that's very a powerful statement. Thank you, Mike, for that. And another guy named John, who's an incredible organizer and has kept the issue of healthcare and financing medical treatment for first responders. He's been keeping that issue at the forefront. And he's representing, you know, thousands, over 100,000 people at this point. And they are proud to have him as a representative, and I can see why, because he's a total badass. John, it's great to get to know you tonight. And he said, you know, let's not make it political. Let's not make it political. It's very basic. Just support healthcare for heroes. Treat heroes like they deserve to be treated. It's very simple. All these first responders who were there, and then another, we talked a little bit with another gentleman, and he said, you know, the never forget. Never forget, he said, you know, it's a bit of a bumper sticker at this point. And I think, you know, he told me that 9/11, you know, obviously horrific, traumatic, despicable, but he says in some ways, 9/12 was awesome. People were coming together. People came together. People came together as one. We were supported by the rest of the planet, almost every other country. And most importantly, in our country, we supported each other. There was a time when we supported each other. So I think that's the part, and that's what he said, that's the part that we cannot forget, that we can stay together and we don't have to wait for another terrorist attack, and we don't have to wait, we don't have to suffer this thing of being divided by other people for their benefit. I don't hate my fellow American citizens, and I don't want them to be told that I hate them either. Politicians are all of a sudden like divorce lawyers, separating the two parties so they can benefit. So let those events that we got through all those years ago, and that these men and women are still courageously healing from, and let those lessons be remembered as our solidarity to come together and keep this country straight, the country that we love and can be loved. Time to go down to the end. Time. We have a David and Goliath situation here. They're smaller, but mighty. Come on. This here is the voice of the back, the power of the back. How loud can I hear the power of the back? What you got? Don't get negative, just get louder. Come on. We're gonna play one for the back. Are you ready, guys? 1, 2, 3, 4, 2. I seem to recognize your face. A long, thing familiar, yeah. I can't seem to place it. Yeah. Can I find a candle of thought to light your name? Daylight times, they're catching on with me. All these changes stay. I wish I'd seen the place that no one's ever taken me. Oh, hearts and thoughts they fade away. Oh, hearts and thoughts they fade away. Yeah. on some more great singing, some of the best of the whole tour. Thank you so much, Madison Square Garden, New York City. I just had to explain something about Canada. We just came down from Canada. We had about 4 shows up there. Pretty great crowds, all good. I think originally there were scheduled 3 shows. We added one more. So we would have extra funds to pay for the fine of going over the curfew when we got to Madison Square Garden.
Yeah.
Let's hear it from Mr. Stone Gossard on guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the best men on the kit, one of the best guys ever on the kit. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Matt Cameron. And on the 4-string bass, the 12-string bass, the stand-up bass, the ukulele bass, also a great songwriter, singer, Mr. Jeff Amen. And we've got another secret weapon in the back. He's gonna come out front and help us on this one. Ladies and gentlemen, covering a lot of territory in the back there. We're so fortunate to have him with us on tour. And his name is Mr. Josh Klinghoffer. And I went to my dressing room, and I believe Harry Styles left this behind last night, so I thought I'd try it on. It's making me nervous, because I think I kind of like it just a little bit. It's Evolution, baby. Josh, you want to play this one with us? You want to start it? I never meant to cause you anything. I only wanted one time to see you laughing. Yeah. I only wanted to see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. We'll be right back.
Oh,
To all the first responders in the room tonight. Thank you again for the courage back then and the courage today. And for reminding us what courage looks like. Thank you so much, New York City. Thank you so much. You don't get to see faces for 2 years and then we get to see yours tonight. We couldn't be happier. Thanks for all the energy. Thanks for all the life. You've given us life, 30 years. We love you. It's the best night ever. Thank you so much. Photogenic. Good night. Love you. Peace.